The USAID Applying Science to Strengthen and Improve Systems Assist Project works in more than 20 countries on building the capacity of service delivery organizations to improve the effectiveness, efficiency, client-centeredness, safety, accessibility and equity of health and family services. The project applies and instills modern improvement methods to advance, strengthen, and sustain quality healthcare and other services for vulnerable populations.
Assist is without question the technical leader in the field of quality improvement, so that really for all a wide range of AID programs, Assist is the go-to source of expertise for quality improvement.
The project focuses on improving healthcare through producing better outcomes, patient satisfaction, efficiency of care delivery, patient-centeredness. It also emphasizes the adoption of improvement methods in the host country governments in which we operate.
Assist also generates new learning and shares knowledge related to the application of improvement science in different settings.
The improvement science methodology is being used currently by the Assist project, looking at over 20 countries where we are implementing continuous quality improvement methodology.
Improvement science is basically a collection of disciplines that include systems engineering, that include health workforce motivation and how people function in complex adaptive systems. It includes the use of statistical methods to be able to see the differences in results.
South Africa faces a high burden of disease, with more than 6 million people living with HIV. Of the age group 15 to 49 years, approximately 18% of individuals are HIV positive. New infections occur daily. The South African National Strategic Plan for HIV, STIs and tuberculosis calls for the implementation of medical male circumcision as part of a comprehensive package of sexual and reproductive health services that have the potential to greatly reduce the number of new HIV infections.
Some observers noticed that in areas where the majority of the males were circumcised, they didn't have as much HIV prevalence as other areas. So from that observation, research was carried out here in South Africa as well, where we wanted to see what the correlation between the circumcision and the reduction in risk for HIV acquisition was.
MMC benefits the HIV prevention strategies by basically reducing the concentration of Langerhans cells inside the foreskin. And those Langerhans cells actually serve as a vehicle for HIV acquisition.
MMC program is one of the biomedical prevention for new infection. So instead of treating for HIV, we rather prevent it.
When you talk MMC, you're talking a program that is not only benefiting the male.
For the female themselves, one of the biggest and most publicized benefits is the reduction in the risk for cervical cancer. But also, once the prevalence in the males go down, in the long run, there'll be less women being infected. So they, in the long run, will also have a reduced risk of HIV acquisition.
The country has developed a framework for scale-up of voluntary medical male circumcision with a target of over 4 million circumcisions for the period 2010 to 2016. This target aims to contribute to halving the number of daily new HIV infections in South Africa.
Highly ambitious target that we had, but it was based on the HIV epidemic, the incidence, the current prevalence of circumcision in the country, and also the prevalence of HIV.
Yes, we need the number, but with quality. Now, how do we control that quality? It's through training.
In South Africa, Assist works with the Department of Health at all levels, providing technical assistance to build capacity in strategic planning, supervision, program review, training and mentorship in HIV prevention and treatment.
To deliver a program like this requires a large number of interrelated processes that have to happen. It's not just a piece of surgery, but it involves record keeping, it involves follow-up visits, it involves identifying patients, it involves counseling. There are many, many, many components to a project, a program like this.
The significance of introducing quality improvement methodologies into any program is that it allows the person that is running the program or those that are involved in the program to be very critical about their program to ensure that the program is effective and efficient.
The project directly supports sites and implementing partners to integrate continuous quality improvement in voluntary medical male circumcision programs.
The CQI, which is continuous quality improvement, was born out of the need, you know, to ensure that there is quality in the circumcision being carried out.
Our key goal is to ensure that males receive safe male medical circumcision, so that then we know that that helps to reduce severe adverse events, and we know that can lead to, for instance, litigations for the government.
In terms of CQI training, we involve everybody. When I say everybody, we involve the National Department of Health, we involve provincial people, we involve the facility manager and staff who are running the VMMC program. We involve the nurse, the doctor, the data capture. We involve the counselor as well.
With the introduction of URC CQI program to us, it helped us. Initially, it was focusing on supported facilities where they would have specific programs. And what we have then since realized was that those facilities were improving. And that's when we then opted as a department to say, let's expand this program. Let's identify even other departmental facilities that are not necessarily supported by the NGOs. Let's expand it and let's translate this CQI program so that at the end of the day, when we talk of medical services and circumcision in our facilities, we talk of the same standard.
Their feedback has been very, very helpful in improving the way we provide services, in also identifying efficiencies in the way we provide services. That's very important because we get to do more with less.
Where we did well, we developed what you call a citizen report. And then where we did not do well, we develop a service delivery improvement plan so that we know how are we going to do with regard to where we did not make and to improve.
We advocate the use of data. Regardless, it's the CQI data, so we advocate that no, that data should be utilized for improvement.
The CQI program that the URC is bringing, I think, is a very important component of every program, because MMC, when I look at it, is an entry point to men's health.
Getting happy clients, happy patients, patients who come back, patients who talk about us, patients who talk about the excellent service they get because of the continuous quality improvement offered by URC.
Since the URC has come, we have an impact because we chose the worst performing facilities as targets for the quality improvement plans.
And we started to engage our facilities to be able to have focal people looking at the VMMC program at facility level. They are even being trained. They even understand now and embrace the VMMC program accordingly as they're supposed to be doing, because they feel there's a system in place to empower them to be able to talk with confidence and authority over VMMC program. As such, facilities, we see the performance now is improving.
In Uganda, it was a pilot, and we successfully demonstrated that indeed it works. The fact that South Africa took it up and has successfully implemented at even a larger scale than Uganda is testimony that indeed the approach works and can help us to address the gaps.
As healthcare workers, the first thing that we are called to do is to do no harm to our patients. Within the circumcision program, in addition to doing no harm, we are here to actually improve the quality of men's lives, to improve the quality of our health population. And I would call upon all of my colleagues, I'd call upon all of my counterparts working within the health programs, working within circumcision services, to really focus on what they are doing. Look at the quality of what you are doing. Ask yourselves, would I offer this kind of health service to my son, to my brother, to my father, to someone who matters a great deal to me? Personalize these services, and then we will get the quality that we need to see in our services.